no place to rest inside. Soon she would bring forth a son. Man was full, so instead he was born in a stable bed. And there his life had just begun. Supposed to know, as she wrapped him in swaddling clothes, that her perfect newborn baby boy would become a sacrifice. Yes, he would run and he would laugh and play, but his manhood would bring the day when for the world he would choose to die. Trees, just one bright star so all could see the way to Bethlehem that winter's night. Many gifts they brought to him, but a greater gift she gave to them, for through her son would come eternal. On that first Christmas morn, when her baby was born, Mary wrapped a present to the world. Oh, Mary wrapped a present to the world.
And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even into Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph, and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart.